In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a course or project roadmap to help your students see where they're going in your course or during their project. This is a really important aspect of UDL, is helping students visualize where they're going. And by creating a roadmap, like I'm going to show you in just a moment, you can help them do that. All right, so I'm going to show you a couple course roadmaps that I've made and I'm using with students. So one is in a Google Level 1 bootcamp that I'm running, or course that I'm running. I've made this map, and it's going to show them all the things. It's interactive, Genially image. And when they click on the interactive pieces, it's going to show them all the things they need to be able to do within that tool. So they know that, you know, in preparing for their Google Level 1 exam, as they go along, they're going to click on each thing and be like, okay, I can do these items. I can do these items. And then as they keep going along the road and they get closer, it shows them, hey, you can also do the fundamentals training at the Google website. And then finally register you for your exam after you've done all these things. So that is one way. This is like an overview of a whole course. Another way is to provide students step-by-step instructions to something. So I've created this roadmap to help my teachers create a course at fall, my new teachers that are coming to my school. So I've led them through all the steps they need to do to set up their course. So first is like organize their course navigation, or the next thing is to create a homepage. So you can use a roadmap for both of these types of things, either navigating what a whole course can look like, or is going to preview the information for a whole course, or giving students step-by-step instructions in a different visual way. All right, so let's get into it. So I created this graphic in Canva, and I'm going to provide you the template for the road here. So yours will look like this. All you'll need to do is add some images, icons that connect to your content. So maybe think about the order that you teach something in a year, and think about the different units and an icon or an image that would really symbolize that well. And all you have to do is go over to the elements and search for that image. And you can find one that you think goes well, and you can add it to your roadmap. All right, so you add all your images, probably put the name of the course up here in the top, left corner, and then you're gonna download it as a PNG. So you're creating your image in Canva, and we're gonna take it over to Genially, and we are going to make it interactive. So let me go here and let me just download this one as an example. So I'm gonna download this roadmap. You have a link for the template below in the description here. All right, so I'm going to take it to Genially. Here's my dashboard, go to my panel. Right. And I'm gonna create an interactive image is the choice that I wanna do. So I'm gonna create Genially, interactive image, create an interactive image, and I'm gonna drag that roadmap that I made in Canva over here. I'm gonna click on it, say accept, crop it how I want it to be, which is basically the whole image. And then I'm gonna add my interactive pieces. And on each interactive piece, you can provide the students as much detail as you want. So maybe the very first unit, it could either link to something in Canvas, or it could just be, you know, maybe your main vocabulary for that unit and main standards of that unit. So here I am, I have my image, and you'll see that whenever I started Genially, it always has two interactive pieces that are purple, and I always just take those away because I just like to start fresh. And so I can, with my interactive elements, add buttons, buttons with text, markers, whatever you like. I really like the buttons, so I usually do this plus button. Pretty universal that, oh, maybe I click there. And then you're gonna drag it to your location on your roadmap. I like to change the color of the button to match my theme, so it's gonna do red. And then I click on the button and I click this little hand, that's the interactivity. And you can either add a tooltip, which would be a small window if you have only a little piece of text or link to provide, a window if you have a lot of text to provide students to read, or directly a link to another website. So maybe if you wanted to link that directly to a module in Canvas, you could 100% do that. So I'm going to press window, I'm going to say course navigation, and then I would put, you know, some bullet points about course navigation that I want my teachers who are creating a course to know, because this is an interactive graphic for them. All right, and so you just keep adding those interactive elements along the way, and that is going to allow students to click. Interactive graphics are shown to have better results because that interactivity is involved. They're not just watching something static or even just watching a static video. They have to click to interact, and that promotes engagement in their learning. So I would love to see the course roadmaps that you create. I'm going to provide this template to you in the description below.